closer than breath. You are the air, sweeter than life itself. You are here. I am a wanderer. You are my peace. I am a prisoner. You are released. Che Gurudev, Che Gurudev, Che Gurudev, Che Gurudev, Che Gurudev.
Sadhguru, Namaskaram. You mentioned in your previous discourses that 30% of the illnesses are body, while the rest are mind-created. I just want to know, in case you do get an illness, how do you know that it's mind-created or it's of the body? And in case it's psychosomatic in nature, what would be the emotional and the thought pattern that's behind it? How would you find that out and correct it if possible? Thank you.
Suppose your right hand gets up and does funny things and smashes you, pokes your eyes, do you have an ailment or no? Yes, isn't it? For sure you have. That's exactly what your mind is doing, isn't it? It gets up, pops around, hurts you, pokes you, makes you cry, makes you suffer. Do you have an ailment or no? If your hand started poking at you, hitting you, beating you up, definitely you are sick, isn't it? Yes. So if your thoughts and emotions are poking you, strangling you, torturing you every day, aren't you sick, I'm asking? So, because this sickness is on, it will manifest in so many ways in the physical body. There is no question anymore. Every thought, every reverberation on the level of the mind, depending upon the type of reverberation you create, the whole chemistry is going through a change. It's all been measured. Right now you sit here and think about tigers, you have one kind of chemistry, chemical changes happen. You think about flowers, another kind of chemical change happens. All this has been measured. So for every thought, if the whole chemistry is going through thing, if your mind is in this state, you know what kind of soup you're making? You're a lousy soup. Not just lousy, poisonous. If you're soaked in this poisonous soup on a daily basis, how to know well-being? It'll not happen like that. We don't have so much control today in the world as to what we eat, what we drink, what we breathe. All of it is somewhat poisoned. Modern societies have started treating disease, ailment, as a natural process, which is a serious mistake. Ancient societies always saw disease as something wrong. That's not how a man should be. A human being should not be in any state of illness, because illness means something fundamentally wrong. But modern societies have started treating this as normal, because there's an industry which thrives on you, very major industry. The second largest industry on the planet is pharmaceuticals. So, if the second largest industry on the planet is pharmaceuticals, they're too much lousy soup, isn't it? Every day you have to add something to this to make it… No. If you're willing, we can make this into a very wonderful soup. The chemistry is in a fantastic state. To be blissful is natural. If you do this, believe me, 70% of the ailments will vanish from the planet. Another 30%, there are many external influences which are not always in control. You cannot control that, only to some extent. So, if you're constantly creating a nasty chemistry within you, how is life within you supposed to understand you're seeking well-being? How? It's just unfair. Life within you thinks he likes ailments and gives it to you. Yes. If you're poisoning your system from within, for which there is substantial proof, for every thought and emotion, the chemical composition of your body is changing, if you're creating poison from within you and you want to live well, how is it? Life doesn't work like that. Unless you do right things will not happen to you.
esa la vida que me ha dado tanto. Me dio dos luceros que cuando los abro perfecto distingo lo negro del blanco y en el alto cielo su fondo estrellado y en las multitudes el hombre que yo amo. Gracias a la vida que me ha dado tanto, me ha dado el oído que en todo su ancho graba noche y días, grillos y canarios, martillos, turbinas, ladridos, chubascos y la voz tan tierna de mi bien amado. Gracias a la vida que me ha dado tanto, me ha dado el sonido y el abecedario, con él las palabras que pienso y declaro, madre, amigo, hermano y luz alumbrando la ruta del alma del que estoy amando. Gracias a la vida que me ha dado tanto, me ha dado la marcha de mis pies cansados, con ellos anduve ciudades y charcos, playas y desiertos, montañas y llanos, y la casa tuya, tu calle y tu patio. Gracias a la vida que me ha dado tanto, me dio el corazón que agita su marco cuando miro el fruto del cerebro humano, cuando miro el bueno tan lejos del malo, cuando miro el fondo de tus ojos claros. Gracias a la vida que me ha dado tanto, me ha dado la risa y me ha dado el llanto. Así yo distingo dicha de quebranto, los dos materiales que forman mi canto y el canto de ustedes que es el mismo canto y el canto de todos que es mi propio canto. Gracias a la vida.